You're walking through the world half asleep. It isn't just that you don't know who you are and that you don't know how or why you got here. It's worse than that. These questions never even arise. It's as if you're in a dream. And then a great horn sounds, calling you to remembrance. But all you can remember is how much you've forgotten. Every day for a month, you sit and try to remember who you are and where you are going. The time of transformation is upon you. The world is once again cracking through the shell of its egg to be born. The gate between heaven and earth creaks open. The book of life and the book of death are open once again, and your name is written in one of them, but you don't know which one. Now is the season. Every soul needs to express itself. Every heart needs to crack itself open. Every one of us needs to move from anger to healing, from denial to consciousness, from boredom to renewal. These are just a few of my favorite insights from Rabbi Alan Liu, found in his spectacular book, This is Real and You Are Completely Unprepared. I share them tonight with you, as I've shared other readings tonight throughout the service with you, because today was Rosh Chodesh Elul. Elul, as I've mentioned tonight, is the Hebrew month directly preceding our High Holy Days. With the arrival of Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, our Aser Yamei Teshuvah, the 10 days of Teshuvah, we embark on a journey of the soul. And Rabbi Liu describes it as a journey from denial to awareness, from self-deception to judgment. This is the journey the soul takes to transform itself and to evolve, the journey from boredom and staleness, from deadness to renewal. It's on the course of this journey that we confront our shadow and come to embrace it, that we come to know our deepest desires and catch a glimpse of where they come from, that we express the paradoxical miracle of our own being and the infinite power of simply being present, simply being who we are. This is such an important journey, and it is one we embark on every year at this time. And while we're told the gates will close at the end of Yom Kippur, to be a Jew means to affirm that the door is never truly closed. God is always calling us, asking us to return, saying it's never too late to turn back. Essential to our worship is the belief that God waits and cares and forgives. There is always a way back, and that is Teshuvah. The entire month of Elul is set aside for this process of Teshuvah. In Elul, we take stock of where we are, and who we are meant to be. We do Teshuvah when we engage in the process of self-reflection and repair. Rabbi Aidan Steinsaltz, who sadly just recently passed away, once wrote that while the Hebrew word teshuva is usually translated as repentance, its meaning is not entirely conveyed by this word. Teshuva is somewhat broader and deeper, meaning also return. The urge to take a look back is prompted by a spiritual disquiet rather than a guilty feeling. Indeed, we feel as if we are no longer the right person in the right place. We feel that we're being outsiders in a world whose scheme of things has escaped us. So we examine the past year and all its facets, take responsibility and set things right. And by doing so, we will recommit to being our best selves. Every year we return to the same themes, but they feel so true right now in a world that has been profoundly disrupted by a global pandemic. This year, we all live with a little uncertainty about safety. Most of us are unable to gather as usual with our families and with our Temple Sinai community. The death toll is catastrophic, and I would argue that the metaphors of this season are even more meaningful and relevant this year than ever before. For example, the themes of brokenness and wholeness take on new resonance. This year, we're facing an unprecedented pandemic. And tonight, as we have entered into our first Shabbat of Elul, we take a broad sweep of the past year, this crazy, strange year, and reflect on what good has been created and what has been broken in our lives. Like every year at this time, we begin the process of Heshbon HaNefesh, taking an inventory of our soul, an accounting of our spirit. Upon finding ways we've missed the mark, we will enter the process of vidui, admitting to ourselves and perhaps to others, and most definitely to God, that we have made mistakes. We stop making excuses and start making changes. This leads to the work of repair, trying to mend things that might have been broken over the past year. Author Sylvia Borstein suggests an important way of accomplishing this restoration. She writes that if you don't know the answer to the question, the answer is always compassion. It is the answer to any question. We want to live with hearts able to resonate with the human experience so that we will meet the world as friends, that we will live in such a way that our mind will be a good neighborhood. In Elul, there are immense opportunities for personal and spiritual growth, achievable through dedicated inner work. Over the centuries, Jews have used tzedakah, prayer, reflection, intentional speaking, and refined eating to maximize these opportunities and seize this spiritual moment. Slowing down, reflecting, welcoming feelings of awe and humility, and being willing to forgive others, ourselves, and even God, help us accomplish this. In an email I sent to the congregation yesterday, I explained that in an effort to help us fully engage in this spiritual work and connect more deeply with the meaning and hope of our High Holy Days, I'll be sharing a daily reflection with our congregation during the month of Elul. I've collected poems, thoughts, and texts that speak to my heart, which I believe can help us engage in meaningful reflection. And I'll be emailing out one a day, except on Shabbat, for the entire month of Elul, which occurs now through September 18th. I hope you'll take the time to read them and contemplate their insight. I hope they will help your soul begin to awaken to this special season, allowing the days of awe to be successful and impactful for your life. Most of our days are filled with ego-based issues, desires, fears, needs. But many of us recognize that something about us is more lasting than our acquisitions, attainments, and accomplishments. What might it be like to look and live deeper? What might it feel like to redress fragmentation in many aspects of our lives? These are the questions posed during the month of reflection that precedes the High Holy Days, and I hope this Shabbat you will all begin to reflect on these questions, these ideas, these themes, opening up your hearts and your souls to the High Holy Day season for a more meaningful Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur than you've ever experienced before. Shabbat Shalom.